don't have anything to do after he's spent like 10, 15 years in education. So this is the one. We started with this one. And I started with them like since 10 months now. I have visited them on Saturday. I really got surprised. I found one of the girls. She did some, like you will show now, some design. The whole presentation, I thought she did the design from the internet, she just downloaded it. And when she explained in details, I said, oh, this girl, maybe she did this design herself. Then I asked her, she did, yes. If you are at this level, I can hire you now. Because I need some designers who can imagine the new product how it looks like. Because all of the great inventions comes from the minds. It's not exist. If it exists, so it's not a great invention. So it comes from the minds, from the like brainstorming, but you need someone to transfuse this brainstorming into design. If the children in this age can do this, they are more powerful than us. They still have a fresh mind. They can think 10,000 meters than us, because we are old already. We are already full of administration and history, and this one already take a lot, but we still young. If we give them the right direction, he will seriously help us to solve all the problems very fast and very quickly. So I will hand over to the students now. He will show the presentation. Then, ready guys? Thank you very much. I'm sorry for like taking long time.
Good morning everyone, I'm John.
And I'm Sayam.
We are from Lit 10. This is our class. This presentation is created by our class and today we'll tell you about it.
What we have learned during our ICT lesson, we have learned how to use word processing software, we have learned how to use spreadsheet software, we have learned how to use database software and how to create a website using HTML. We learned how to design 3D models and print using a 3D printer. This is an example of a website we created during our ICT lesson using HTML.
Another thing we learned during our ICT lessons is about 3D printing. We learned the fundamentals of it and the different practical uses of it. And before I go on about 3D printing, I would like to again thank Mr. Ramadan for helping us dive into this 3D printing voyage. As you might remember Mr. Ramadan mentioning a girl creating some 3D print models. This is one of the models she had created. She based this model on this papaya tree stem and she used a website called Tinkercad to make it into a 3D printer model so she can print it. These are some of the other models that she had created, and on the left she had created a dragon. And on the right, she has created a couch. So if you want to hire her, feel free to. And then, thank you for watching our presentation. I hope you enjoyed it.
You're free to ask them questions. I didn't tell them, but I think they will be ready to take. If you have any questions related to IT or how they incorporate IT into their curriculum or they themselves do presentations in the class, just feel free to ask. Joy is the taller one, Siam is the slightly shorter one, and there's one more tall one here, Khaled. Khaled, step out. He does a lot of this. He doesn't like to present and answer unless he's in a smaller group, right? Khaled, he will come out of that. And this is Satya. So four of them will take your questions.
Yes. Are you all year 10?
Yes, we all, four of us are year 10.
How old are all of you?
I am turning 15 this year. He is also turning 15. He is turning 17. And he is also turning 15.
Thank you.
Do you start this technology program in year 10 or do you start at a younger age?
We actually started this since last year during the December holidays. Also, we came and Mr. Ramadan took us to trips to his office in German Center where he first introduced us to 3D printing.
It's Dr. Ramadan, okay?
I mean, Dr.
He's
Ramadan.
He's so nice because little boy is in our school in year 3, so they are like his children as well, so they are very familiar. There's formality for that.
Yes.
What process do you find the most challenging when you're going through
this 3D printing?
Yeah, creating it and designing it, and what's
honestly, personally, I feel the creating a model, it takes way too much of patience, which I don't have. Like the dragon model, it took my friend Tafoy, I think 2 to 3 weeks. I don't think I had that much patience.
She's going to do a dance, that's why she's not here. There's a question here.
Yes.
What are your favorite things to do and why?
In ICT or overall?
Both.
Okay. I do like creating the different things using the 3D printing. 3D printer, but it's only the modeling that is patience consuming.
The others can answer as well. Joy, what is your answer to that question?
What do you like?
Creating a model.
I like creating unique models with this 3D printing.
Siam has been with us from 2016. 2016, okay. We were not a education school, which is a different, Mr. Bajan will explain later. Joy and Siam both joined in 2016. Satya joined us 2020, and this boy Khaled in 2021. Right?
You know the stereotype about you must have 10 years to do O-level, does not hold true. That young man standing there, we had a language program where a group of 11 kids did a 10-year program in 2 years. And all of them except one had distinction. And one of them is a member of parliament in this country. Siam is doing the 10-year program in 7 years. We haven't taken him to the whole 10 years. He's doing it in, and what is holding our kids back? There is a genius in every child. We suppress the biggest, can I leave this room after I say this word? The biggest criminals on the surface of this earth are people who call themselves teachers. Teachers, yes. You think a child must do these X syllables in 10 years? Nonsense. When I was one of those crazy principals, my superintendents hated me. They hated to come to my school. They hated my school. They loved my school, but they hated me. Because each time they came, they had to sit outside. They got to sit outside. They are my boss. So when I'm sorry, I was with my boss. And you are not my boss, sorry. You will set me, go ahead. My boss is the child. My boss is the child. Now, children, they are fantastic. And that is what Lotus is about. So he is a living example, 7 years. And all of them just joined. Just joined because we don't market or anything. They just join, and some of them are doing it in 5 years, 6 years, a 10-year program. You know. So we like to share with you more things. Thank you very much.
And I have Miss Swati wants to say something. She's the ICT teacher.
By the way, this lady is only been with us for a couple of months, and when.
Good morning, esteemed guests. So, I would like to add on to this presentation. So, learning 3D objects, we learned how to create 3D objects when I was doing engineering first year. So, around 18, the students will be around 18 to 20 years. And the students here in Lotus Bridge School, they're learning at the age of 14 to 15 years, which is appreciating.
Now I will hand over to Mr. Bhajan Singh for his section on the overview of the speech.
Please listen. Cut out this formality.
You don't want the mic?
No, I don't need the mic. If I need a mic in a classroom, I'm not a teacher.
All right, let me share, Mr. Singh.
That's a teacher. Your biggest teaching aid is not the silly AI. There is a big battle going on in the world about AI, right?
Okay, I want to do a dialogue. This is something you do not know. He was my teacher in 1976. Now, I want to get his attention. I can't because he was my teacher. So can
she,
I have
she
one
still,
minute?
She's still terrified up to today. If I ever walk into a meeting and she's, hi, there is Sam, the
Sam's
lovely young daddy, man.
The one there is Sam's
He's also on the parent support group also.
Alright, why I'm using the microphone is because I can help Dave for his editing and the sound. Otherwise, the camera will not capture the voice quality.
Okay,
that's why.
I
thank you.
Okay, look, look. If you, we offer you this. Don't bring in people here for 4 hours, 3 hours. They're going to learn nothing. Bring in people, leave them here for 1 week. They can sleep on the roadside. Yes, I slept on the roadside as a little child. Year 6, year 7, year 8, year 9, year 10, year 11, year 12, year 13. I slept on the roadside because I was an orphan. I had no parents. So, please think about it. It's an offer. Okay, look, we cannot share with you everything. There are a lot of mysteries, and one mystery is this. You don't put the child in an incubator and 10 years or 12 years later say you're going to become a successful industrialist, entrepreneur, this and that, or we'll put you through the mill and you will become a doctor. You got to bring in the careers and industries into the school. And this is the beginning. Mr. Ramanand's commitment, he's got a fantastic young son. He is so fast. He loves football and he loves running. So we always got to look, where is he now? Brilliant son he's got. And he's going to help us to bring in more. We need to bring industry into the school. By the way, I learned something. You learn very little from books. Okay? So we're going to telescope. In a short period of time, you're going to have only 30 minutes in the classroom. The classroom is a boring place. I learned nothing in the classroom. I used to argue and make my teachers cry. Yes, I say, Miss Theo, what are you teaching me that I can use in life? Nothing. I can't use any of. Then I used to argue with my Christian brother, Brother Patrick, Brother Kylie. I say, brother, you wear all white robes. Huh? You don't even live a normal life. What can I learn from you? Teach me something how to survive in the real world. So look, book knowledge is book knowledge to be kept in the books. The real teacher is out there. You know, like driving, you pass your driving, but you only pass when you go into the traffic. When the first thing I went to US, I nearly had 3 accidents in 15 minutes. Then I forgot. Hey, look, in Singapore, I'm a left-hand driver. This car is right-hand. So I panicked. It was in San Francisco. And I quickly looked for a car park. I looked for a car park. And I spent next 30 minutes steering, finding my bearing, and so on and so forth. So real knowledge is out there. So you have 30 minutes out there with some kids with the teacher. Each teacher will be doing something, and then we will assemble here to reconvene.
All right, children, you can sit down. All children, you may sit. Miss Aino Rama and Miss Emmeline Coulson, can you please come over to the front? Thank you. All of you can sit anywhere, doesn't matter. Although we have put the color coding, it's all right. Just there are seats on the other side as well. Just move to the front and move to the other side. Parent support, you can also move in. Student council, can you do your ushering if you are available? Teachers, please help. Thank you. Children? Here, there is another seat on this side. Michael, you would like come this side? No, you're fine. Okay. Can you come over this side? Yeah. Now, children, I know you have been waiting, and just now, our guests were in your classes, and they had a very good time, from what I hear. They will be watching you in a short while. So you're okay? Yeah. Very good. So I'm going to hand over to the MC for the day. MCs for the day, can you get your mics? Yes. I'm going to be quiet now, okay, children? You'll do your best. Thank you.
I am Nuha.
I am Nafisa.
Good morning, our esteemed guests from Global Education Allies, our distinguished parents from Parent Support Group, Mr. Bajang Singh, Dr. Kaur, teachers and friends.
This morning, we had presentations done by our students and teachers in the classroom. Now, we hope you enjoy our welcome dance, the Bhangra! What an amazing performance done by our Bhangra dancers. Now, we will be inviting the Year Trees to perform I Have a Voice. Let's welcome them to the stage.
Hello everyone, my name is Irene. I'm a Year Tree student. Today we're going to sing a song, I Have a Voice. It is about the strength we hold in our voices and speaking the truth. It also represents the vows we hold in Lotus Bridge International School.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Ayan. I am from Bangladesh, and I am from Year 3.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Omar, and I am from Egypt, and I am from Year 3.
I have a voice, simple and clear. It speaks the truth for all to hear.
It gives me hope, it gives me faith.
It lifts me up, it keeps me safe.
I have a voice, it's mine alone.
It comforts me.
I wish that you could hear it too.
Thank you. Next, our classmates will share what we learned in our coding class.
Good morning, esteemed guests, Dr. Kaur, Mr. Bhajan Singh, teachers, and my dear friends. Today, we are going to talk about four stages of creating an app. We create applications for a purpose. I am going to talk about the first stage. It's defining the goal. Now I should pass the mic to my friend.
Good morning, everyone. I am Subhashree. I'm going to talk about the second stage of creating an app. It is design. Design is nothing but you decorate your app with your creativity. It is all about look and feel of our application. We can also decorate our app by changing the color of the screen and the font sizes. Now I shall pass it to my other friend to talk about the coding stage.
Hi everyone, my name is Arush and I'm going to talk about the third stage of creating an app, coding. Coding is giving instructions to a computer in computer language. In our app, we instructed the computer to take the number from the text inputs, add them all up, and show the result on the third text input. That's it for the coding stage. Now I'll pass the mic to my friend Omar.
Hi, my name is Omar, and I'm going to talk about the fourth stage. Testing. Testing is important to see if our app is working or not.
Are you all excited to see what we made? It just took 10 minutes to create it. It calculates two apps and gives us the result. Let's see. Thank you.
That was quite informative. Imagine creating an app at the age of 8.
Now for our next performance, it will be the Bengali dance. The Bengali dance will be performed by our schoolmates. The song they'll be performing is called Ajay Dhaner Khete. Ajay Dhaner Khete was a Bengali song released in 2017. It talks about harvesting wheat under the sun and playing hide and seek in the wheat field. The Bengali dance, please. That was a spectacular performance by our Bengali dancers. Let's give them a round of applause.
Next, we'll have a little princess from the frozen world of Arendelle. Let's welcome Ellie Alina onto the stage.
The snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolations, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like
like the swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I've tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. Go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go. Turn away and slam the door. I don't care what they're going to say. Let the storm rage on. The cold never bothered me anyway. It's funny how some distance makes everything seem small, and the fears that once controlled me can't get to me at all. It's time to see what I can do to test the limits and break through. No right, no wrong, no rules for me. I'm free. Go, let it go. I'm one with the wind and sky. Let it go, let it go. You'll never see me cry. Here I stand and here I stay. Let the storm rage on. My powers flourish through the air and through the ground. My soul is spiraling in frozen fractals all around. One thought crystallizing like an icy blast. I'm never going back. The past is in the past. Back anymore. Let it go, let it go. That perfect girl is gone. Here I stand in the light of day. Let the storm rage on. The cold never bothered me anyway.
That was a melodious performance from our little princess.
Our music teacher, Miss Thumb, prepares us for solos, duets, and choir.
Next, we'll have a Year 4 presentation. Year 4, please.
Good morning, teachers and friends. I am Francesca from Italy in year 4. Today we will perform Touch the Sky. Thank you.
I am from Beethoven, the most admired composer of Western music, symbolizing perseverance.
I am from Confucius, the wisest Chinese philosopher whose teaching focuses on family loyalty and respect for elders, symbolizing wisdom.
I am from Nightingale. The lady with the lamp was a British nurse and a social reformer, symbolizing servicing to humanity.
I am from Tagore. Tagore was a great philosopher, writer, artist, and Nobel Prize winner, symbolizing scholastic achievements.
Our language program allows us to experience and use our language effectively through various modes of learning. Let's hear the year 6 and 7 in English and the year 4 in Hindi.
Because they'll be fighting with the sword, right?
No.
Good morning, Dr. Kaur, Mr. Singh, teachers, audience, and fellow classmates. My name is Soman. I'm from Year 6 Loyalty, and I will be representing a pirate for our CCA program. Characters come alive. Now, scarf, eye patch, parrot. Now, which pirate am I? Who am I? I am Long John Silver from Treasure Island. The reason I chose this character is because I think he's a well-known character, as he a well-taught character, because he shows as a hero in the start and ends up as a villain. Now I'll be acting as him. Ahoy there, Mr. Merry. You call these rebel pirates? You call these rebel pirates? I would. What's that line again? You call these rebel pirates? Oh my God. You call these rebel pirates? I need me a proper crew to get me hands on the treasure. Flint's treasure! Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I am Asha from Year 6 Loyalty. Today I'll be acting as Dr. Jekyll from the book Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Dr. Jekyll is a protagonist. He is a scientist. He is affected by a disorder called split personality. Now I'm Mr. Hyde. Mr. Hyde is the antagonist of the book. He is the one who killed Sir Danvers Carew, who is the vice politician of London. Now I'll be acting as Mr. Hyde. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Mashvi and I'm from Year 7. School-based reading is an integral part of the school curriculum. For this year, my classroom, which is Year 7, have read the book called Great Expectation, which is written by Charles Dickens. To make it interesting, my classmates and teacher have thought of dramatizing it. So here is a short snippet of the drama that we created. Hope you enjoy. Thank you.
What's your name?
The past pictures.
Pizza. Do you know what are virtual and files are?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Bring me virtual files or your aunt and neighbor will be torn down.
Scared for his life.
Captain Pip again and again. Pip felt dreadfully frightened and giddy. The man then held Pip by the arm and said,
"You bring me what to me, you shall be led to live. There's a young man hidden with me.
He
will make sure that you will suffer. Now go, boy."
In comparison, the convict attacking Pip is
Pip ran in the speed of lightning.
Then he just runs from the
car. Mr. and Mrs. Joe Gargery is a very ill-tempered woman and would not hesitate to hit Pip with a stick. Meanwhile, Joe is a very good-tempered and sweet guy who Pip would share all
over
his
here is
with.
Mr. Joe, who is the
home
blacksmith.
After the acquaintance with the old man, horrified.
Over here, Pip
there
is
you are,
running,
where have you
running
been?
And panting.
Mrs. Joe. Mrs. Joe has been looking for you a dozen of times. She has a cane, you know.
Pip has to be scared by now. She has a cane.
Where have you been? Being married to a blacksmith is enough for me. Now I have to take care of you also.
Here, Mrs. Joe is getting mad at Pip. Gunshots have been shot.
What was that?
Pip
gunshots,
hears it.
Oh, lad. Another convict must have escaped.
Another convict?
Yes.
Who is shooting?
The hogs, you boy. What is it?
The food is getting served by Mrs. Joe.
Boy,
both
ask
of them.
No questions and you'll be told no lies. And that's it. Eat and go to bed.
Okay.
That night, Pip was confused with his feelings. He felt guilty to be stealing the food from his sister's pantry.
It was at midnight and he had no idea
of
what to
do.
He was in terror.
He will be
he had two decisions
in
mind. Either
man
get the food and go to
the
convict or just stay in the house.
He went down and stole victuals from his sister's pantry.
He decided
and
to give it to
the brothers-in-law's shop.
He sneaks down the stairs slowly so that no one can hear the noise. Steals the food.
Oh,
and here are the rituals.
Okay.
Then he runs. Well, that's it. Thank you.
My name is Moksh. I'm from Year 4 Confidence. I'm going to summarize a story for you. There was a rich woman. She had only one son. Her son fell into bad company. Seeing this condition of her son, she was worried day and night. The rich woman got an idea. Apple from the supermarket and keep them in a basket. The rich woman also kept a rotten apple in their basket. A few days later, the rich woman asked her son to cut open an apple. Her son saw that all the apples were rotten. The rich one explained to her son that just how one bad apple can spoil all the others, one bad company can ruin a man's life. Thank you.
That was a great performance. Okay. We at Lotus Bridge International School have been inspired by our Da Vinci Creativity Program. In 2021, we participated in the Science Buskers competition, and we became national champions.
In 2022, we clinched 2 Judges Award in Science Creativity.
Now, without ado, let me hand over to the Year 5 and 6 science project presentations.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Suhaila, and these are my classmates, Vivan and Yamili. We are from year 6. We had a very interesting hands-on activity. Everyone went to the school garden and nearby areas to pick up Ixola flowers from the ground. In the classroom, we dissected the flowers and, with the guidance of our science teacher, Dr. Needy, we identified and learned about the flowers. It was more interesting and meaningful than reading about it in the textbook.
For the topic of digestive system, we had yet another hands-on activity. We had a science and art hybrid class.
With the help of our art teacher, Madam Maksuda, we used balloons to make a model of the whole digestive system.
We had never used balloons like that.
And we had so much fun being creative.
Thank you.
That was informative.
But that was not all. Next, we have our Year 10 Geography students.
Good morning, our esteemed guests from Global Education Allies, Mr. Singh and Dr. Kaur. I am Tarat.
And I am Bindu.
And we both are from year 9/10. Today, we both will present to you about our geography fieldwork. So, what is a wow moment? It is a moment when a classroom experience makes learning joyful and engaging. These moments often have a lifelong impact to students. For our geographical fieldwork, there are 3 stages. These stages can neither be put in different order nor have one of it missing. In other words, these stages of a geographical fieldwork come in a package. Our geographical investigation lessons kicked off with an intro to research. The lesson was presented by our virtual speaker, Mr. Kenji Kimura, and co-taught by our teacher, Ms. Marina. Mr. Kimura is a researcher and data analyst. He has done plenty of urban surveys throughout Asia Pacific in the past 10 years. Mr. Kimura gave us an overview of research process and methods, as well as data presentations and analysis that morning.
Before we went out for the fieldwork, we prepared some questionnaires, did some quizzes, and even went on a virtual cycling trip via Google Maps. On the day of our fieldwork, we stood by Jalan Besar Road and counted the number of vehicles that passed by. We found out that it was difficult to manually count the number of vehicles that pass by. We wish for more fieldwork in the future. Thank you.
That was informative.
The next performance is by Year 5. They'll be doing a song, Never Giving Up. Let's invite Year 5 onto the stage.
Good morning, esteemed guests, Mr. Singh, Dr. Kaur, and fellow schoolmates.
Today we are performing the song Never Give Up. This song reminds us to reach for our dreams.
Every week we set academic and non-academic goals. At the end of the week, we review our goals and push ourselves to try harder even when it's difficult.
We hope that this song inspires you and changes your life in a positive way. Thank you. Expect of me. I want to be proud of who I'm becoming. It's time for me to make a change. Start living the life I want.
I'm gonna reach for the skies, way up high. I'm never giving up.
I'm never giving up.
That was a very beautiful and motivating song by the Year 5s.
The next performance will be by the Year 7, who are singing a song called See You Again by Wiz Khalifa. Now let's give a round of applause for them.
Russia. We had such a good time together.
Yeah, we also had a friend from Ukraine. Hope the war ends soon.
Year 7 is going to present a soulful and uplifting touch of song with a poignant chorus reminding us that even though our loved ones may be gone, their memory will live on forever. This powerful song captures the depth of human emotion and enduring nature of love and friendship.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see.
Dang, who knew all the planes we flew, good things we've been through, that I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place, see you in a better place.
Without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
A long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Should both go watch away, and the vibe is feeling stronger. And what small tend to what friendship, and friendship tend to what bond, and that bond will never be broken, love will never get lost.
And the brotherhood come first, and the line will never be crossed. Establish it on our own, and the line had to be drawn. And the line is what we reach. So remember me when I'm gone. When I'm gone.
When I'm gone.
You take will always lead you home, It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
Oh.
That was quite a heartwarming performance.
The next performance will be by our Indian dancers. They'll be doing a song called Mugunda Mugunda, which praises Lord Krishna, who takes different forms to save the world.
Now, let's invite the Indian dancers.
School, I would like to thank each and everyone for taking the time on this special occasion.
Now, I would like to invite Dr. Kaur on stage to give away the token of appreciation. Dr. Kaur, please.
Thank you. Shashi, where are you? Miss Melo, can you get me Shashi over? Now everyone, just you must have seen the hall empty. Turn around, look back, just the last few students are there. Uh-huh. They have quietly gone away. Their buses are waiting, school buses at 12 o'clock. So today they have gone. And I'm actually waiting for one of the staff to honor all of you. I have something as a memento for everyone formed on behalf of the school. And I think, just give me a minute. At the back of the hall, do you see anything on the tray? Otherwise, Mr. Singh, when you are at the lunch venue, I'll bring it over. I actually have something to present to Ms. Aino and everyone to take away as a memento. But obviously, one of the staff who's handling this is also handling the buses. So I'll do that. Not to worry, everyone. Oh, it's there. Good. Come, Kali, bring it over. Good. That's right. It's year 7, 8, 9. After this, we will all head back to the school, okay? I think all of them, did you all enjoy what the students put up for you? Yeah. All the students who, teachers, can you assist me so that you can let everyone have a token which will they will take back? Ms. Tam, I also would like to thank Ms. Tam for putting together the entire musical performance. Our music teacher, Ms. Tam. You didn't have a chance to interact with her just now because she was here, but she will probably be joining us for lunch, and you, all of you who teach music and want to know how she got so many students to do, just so you can actually interact with her. Miss Tam, you have a busy lunch in a while. Okay. And now I would like to invite Madam Milia to help us give away the token of appreciation to Miss Aino. Madam Milia is our dear friend. Milia, can you come forward to help us to give away the Miss Aino, please? Yes, Aino. Thank you, everyone. Now, Mr. Bajan, it's all to you. We are all going to disappear there. Students, can you, teachers, please bring them back to the school and... Oh, this for me?
We have some small tokens of appreciation for Lotus Bridge, or maybe more so for the staff room, for the teacher's lounge. Last time we came here, it was 2019, and little did we know what was going to happen next. And we're so glad that borders have opened and we get to visit you again. And we want to remind your teachers that, that when they're taking care of you and your well-being students, that they should also remember to take care of themselves. They have a very busy schedule, so we got something for the teacher's lounge called Rest to Reset, the busy person's guide to pausing with purpose. It's important for us to take care of our own well-being, so. And then as we have two university groups, I'd like to recognize the professors who are with us, Dr. Stewart, Dr. Murray, Dr. Patch, I can't see them all, and Dr. Oh, that's right, I'm so sorry. I call them by their first names, so. And Dr. Ashcraft, right, Carrie, and so they're with us here today, and they have two student groups with them, future teachers, and they are from the state of Utah, from the United States, and we have brought some taffy, which is made with the salt from the Great Salt Lake. It's an old, ancient lake. Most of it is gone, but there's still salt left over from it, and it's made from this. This company has been around for over 100 years. So hopefully you'll get to enjoy this in the teacher's lounge. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ms. Aino, and the entire team. When we meet after so long or after so short, it's just so nice to just find that little bit of times where we can have interactions which are very, very meaningful for our future generations. But before I move on, I would like to invite Ms. Aino to give away a token of appreciation to our very supportive parent, Dr. Ramadan, from our parent support group. Dr. Ramadan, please. Rama and Ramadan. Yes. Miss Aino Rama presented to Dr. Ramadan. Very memorable moment.
And just a moment, you students have been an inspiration. You have been incredibly fun to watch, and maybe just the last applause from our teachers to you one more time, the real stars of the show tonight. Yeah.
All right, all the children, Miss Dr. Needy, Miss Radha, can you please bring them away? And the group, please stay on here for a moment, okay? Thank you. Children, please move back to the school in your usual orderly manner.
A little bit from Weber State.